Good morning, Clinton. Where in the world are you currently?
It's 8 p.m. now, so not good morning to me, but good morning to you. I am in Vancouver, Canada. It's very depressing here.
Yeah?
It's just like rainy.
I do think it's kind of cool though. Like it's kind of like a purgation aspect before Christmas. Like everything kind of gets washed away towards that end of the year.
I see what you mean. Yeah, it's yeah.
My first question is, if you were not Clinton Kane, would you be a fan of Clinton Kane?
You see, if I answer yes, that would be a little too self-centered. If I
Would it?
answer no, I am recommending people not to be a fan of me. So you're kind of just putting me in a rock and a hard place, mate.
I mean, like it's that concept of you're writing to heal yourself, right? So if that's the case, then your
Would
antidote
be a
would,
fan. I would be a fan.
right? Yeah.
I would be the biggest fan. Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna throw a whole bunch of like speed round questions just to get to know Clinton Kane a little bit more.
Okay. I'm very bad at this, but let's do it.
It'll be fun, I promise. Okay, favorite TV show growing up was.
Bruh. I didn't watch a lot of TV growing
You
up.
did not? What were you, a
But
gamer?
no, I just was outside.
Okay. This concept of outside is so foreign, I bet. What is your go-to McDonald's order, or do you not eat McDonald's?
Oh, I love Maccas. Probably a Big Mac, large fries, extra saltiness, a large Sprite, and a chocolate milkshake.
Ooh, specific. Okay, well, when you come to Singapore, it's not really a Singaporean dish, but we have this thing in Singapore called the McSpicy Double. It is like a chicken sandwich, but it's really spicy. Like, I can't eat it.
I love spice. I just can't do it well.
You just gotta do it once with like a bottle of milk next to you.
I'll do it.
Yeah.
We can do it together if you want to. I'm
I'm
down.
down. I haven't actually had a McSpicy in ages. Next one. How many pillows do you have on your bed when you sleep at night?
Two. More than two, I just can't do it. I've dated a girl once who had like 12,
Yep.
and I mean, you know how that ended. We broke up because a red flag.
Dude, I have like five pillows because, let me explain, I build a fort when I sleep, right? So I have to be protected from all sides, from the ghosts,
Oh,
you
so you
know?
actually like put it on the left and the
Yeah.
right.
Yeah. That way I'm always like leaning against something. You should try that. It's good.
I'm okay.
It helps anxiety for real. And that and like a weighted blanket.
I have a weighted blanket, so we're all
Yeah.
good there.
I was introducing actually your music to my co-host, and she likes your name a lot. She thinks if you could be in the MCU, would you be a hero or a villain? Or we could do the Taylor Swift thing and be an anti-hero.
I would be a hero, but I would like to be a villain.
Like, I think we always start off thinking like, oh, we're gonna be heroes, and then we get all that power,
Yeah,
and then you
I would
realize.
like to be a villain. Yeah, I would like to be a villain. I think that'd be
Yeah.
great. I hope he treats you better than I ever could. 'Cause you deserve the world times two and our simple Sunday afternoons. I hope he's
The
all
song
for
itself, I
you
mean, it's
when the
something that I think a
time
lot of people
passes.
struggle with, like responding to someone who does not choose them.
Yeah.
Some people react to that with salt. Some people go into their insecurities. Bless you. It's okay. And you're instead wishing them well.
Yeah.
Does that come naturally for you when in the face of
No.
rejection? No.
No, what are you talking
Right?
about? Oh, no, I'm the same wretched human being everyone else is. It's not I'm not like a better person. No, it takes a lot of time. It takes a lot of patience. It takes a lot of just growing up, I feel like, you know what I mean? I mean that specific relationship with, I hope, you know, acceptance took 15 years.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, you know?
We gotta talk about love, which
Okay.
is at the heart of the music that you make.
Right.
What do you say to people who have fallen out of love with love?
What do I say to people who have fallen out of love with
With
love?
love. Their relationship with love is sour to a point where they're not even interested in putting themselves out there anymore. They're deleting their Tinder profile.
That would be me.
And there too, to be honest.
That would be me. Can't do it anymore. Too much. It's not worth the songs. It's not worth the money. It's not worth any of this.
Right.
Heartbreak is just too much. It's not
Yeah.
worth it. That's my advice to all of you. It's not worth it. Just stop.
And it still stings, doesn't it? It's like you learn from one breakup and you think you're going to go into the next one and with the lessons.
Yeah, all over again. Yeah. It's the same cycle. Oh my God, so tiring.
The irony, though, is so I used to work in a wedding video company, and I know for sure, I have a friend at least, who uses I Guess I'm in Love for their wedding playlist. I know lovely. A lot of people do, very ironically, put your music in their wedding playlist when they get married and stuff. What songs would you include in your playlist, say you do get married one day?
I've always had a dream of my wedding day.
Yeah.
I want it to be exactly like how Twilight happened, where it's outdoor and there's tall trees and lights all around, and that's the only form of light, and it's going to be, I'm going to be standing there, and the reception is just going to be a huge mansion right there. No need to go anywhere, no need for anything else. Like, I don't know where it's going to be. I'm going to figure it out. I'll figure it out. But my wife will be walking down to 1,000 Years by Christina Perry. And that's
going to say,
there is no other song that it's going to happen except that song.
Will you be nothing else? That song though? Will you? I mean, you can.
No, I'm going to have Christina Perry come here and sing that.
Hire her.
What are you talking about?
Of course. Okay. So I have a friend, Rachel Mack, who, funny, she doesn't know I'm doing this interview. She actually sent me, the website to your show here in Singapore, and she was like, hey Josh, have you heard of this guy Clinton Kane? We should go. So I'm gonna surprise her. Could you say something to Rachel? So I'll tell you something about her. So she has been listening to your music because she's been going through a really tough period in her life.
Cool.
And she's listened to your album over and over, and she does also believe that things will be okay at the end. What would you say to Rachel?
Hi Rachel, you know, from experience, I don't think things will be okay in the end. Not to be a Debbie Downer even more than I am. It's like kind of 50% hope, but also hopeless. But can't wait to see you at the show. Love you so much.
Okay, well, before I go, I'll tell you like one thing that I am doing, because I do connect with your energy and I guess your perspective on life. What I'm currently doing and practicing in my life is that the most important thing you'll ever do is what you're doing right now. So right now you're in Vancouver. If you're gonna do a show there, that is the most important thing you'll ever do, and that's it. Like, there's nothing else. And the next time you go on a date, that'll be the most important thing you'll ever be a part of. So like, one thing at a time, just take it real slow and try to enjoy it.
Yeah,
I really want that for you, just like person to person.
Yeah, it's like, I don't know, it's like hard for me to like appreciate things that come, you know what I mean? Like, yeah, I definitely do enjoy it in the moment for sure. Like, I it's very, very easy for, like, it comes very naturally for me to live in the present. Yeah. So when I am doing something, like, I give it my all. If I'm on a show doing something, like, I'm very much in there. I think what I lack is just like appreciating things that are happening. I think a lot of people lack that too. You just keep moving forward and forward and forward and forward. You keep moving. And it's like, you forget to appreciate the little things, but I appreciate you so much. Thank you.
Yeah. Break the cycle. So whatever that you're supposed to be doing in some little way, just break the cycle. Like, choose the other t-shirt, choose like the other thing from the menu that you don't usually order. Like, don't get the Big Mac, you know?
No, I'll get the Big Mac.
Kiss 92. All the great songs in one place.